Thank you. Gormaha Gort, Cahaloch. It's with a heavy heart that I stand up here this evening to comment on this, and I'll come to Mint, Dr. Scally, Professor Scally, on doing the work and coming forward with this, you know, supplementary report and the scoping inquiry into the cervical check screening programme. It's just a fiasco, Minister. We now know that the latest Scally report identified that the number of laboratories involved in cervical check was greater than originally believed. Initially, it was believed that there were 6 labs, which increased to 11. But in this supplementary report, it was established that there were at least 16 labs that were used, spread across Ireland, England and the USA. The report also shows that requirements for a written permission from the HSE needed before outsourcing were not met, and that a particular concern was the laboratory used in Scotland, UK. And what is so systematically and fundamentally wrong with the HSE, Minister, that you preside over, that, you know, basic principles of good governance are just blatantly ignored? As I said, the report has established that there were these 16 labs, and we thought it was 6, and then we thought it was 11. And we know that the requirements were that they need written permission from the HSE. So who in the HSE is going to be held accountable? Or where, or when, or who? It just beggars belief that the lack of accountability and the lack of respect that people have for the quality of life that people have and their health. It also found, the scoping report, that the right systems were not in place, are only technically in place, they were not being operated properly, or they didn't have the expertise needed. I mean, this wouldn't happen in a roads project. It wouldn't be accepted. Not to mind to say, we're talking about women's health. Women have got life sentences here. Women have died. And many more women are on life sentence. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable. And it gets worse and worse and worse and worse. And you're still in your position as Minister. Nothing personal with you, but I mean, and partly on my right here, keep voting confidence in you. I can't believe it. And then they come in and try and play a double dance given out about you. It just doesn't wash. Is the HSE going out of its way to make this situation worse than it already is? Because that's what it appears to be, making a bad situation worse and worse and worse and worse. And why is there nobody held accountable? Nobody. Has the HSE learned nothing in terms of transparency and accountability? We know they haven't, because it gets worse, worse by the hour. We also know that that a review is being conducted by the Royal College of Obstetricians in the UK. The review aims to give an independent examination of the screening history and results and identify if there was failures by the National Cervical Screening Programme to detect underlying abnormal cells that could have led to cancer, or to intervene at an earlier stage in the development of the patient's cancer. Where is that review now, Minister? Where is that review? Do we have any sense that it will be completed in the time frame that has laid out in terms of reference? Do we have any sense of that? Do you have any sense of that? How can you have confidence when all these, you know, such an unmitigated disaster after disaster? And also, when people died, like Vicky Feeling, like we'll see the Ruth Morrissey case now, and we'll see where, you know, after spending so many days in court, and now you're going to appeal the judgment, and it beggars belief that you would force that on any family again. And as regards the tribunal, Minister, I have no faith whatsoever. We've seen it back to the beef tribunal. Acres and acres of pages of print, and millions upon millions upon millions of barristers' fees, and nothing out of it, any of them. So what are we going to have out of this tribunal either? More fat cats getting fatter, and more massive expenses to the state, with a huge avoidance of any prosecutions of anybody, or any intent to prosecute, and any intent of any semblance of fairness or justice for the victims and their families. I have no faith in any tribunal, because we had bad experience after another for the last number of 3 decades with tribunals. And when are we going to learn? When we got to the Taoiseach brought us up to the briefing recently about the IBRC one. One module, we're at now, and it's gone years over there, and millions beyond where what it should have cost. So I have no faith in this gravy train. I want honesty and decency and respect for the women and their families.
Just Deputy McGrath, just inadvertently you referred to Mrs. Phelan as not being with her.
Sorry. I don't think you meant it. I did not know.
I don't think you meant it.
No, I'm very sorry. Yeah.